Hello, everybody. Welcome to Nogoterra Odyssey. How is everybody? So I'm going to use two of my super fun decks, a gorgeous forest creatures tarot underneath. So you're going to pick your own stack according to the face card or maybe the gem next to it or the number or whatever entices you. And we have three choices. And what this read is going to be about is your guides and angels' messages for you and what is coming in the next 6 months. This is all the news, the scoop on everything, love, career, creativity, whatever comes in. However, I am hearing a few messages for all of you guys right now, and Spirit wants you to know that you are going to find your alignment. Abundance is arriving. You will find pleasure and joy in your life, be motivated towards things that you love and your endeavors, and you are moving into a place of authenticity where you're not afraid to speak your truth and you feel stronger than ever. You're guided by your intuition and your deep loving heart, which is going to bring you to the right places. And we stop chasing ghosts. We stop having tug of war with ghosts, stupid, meaningless things that we think are important because it's constantly on social media or whatever, but absolutely ridiculous, petty things just dying away like the dead leaves falling off the trees. That's what fall is all about, letting it fall away. Let all those embers just turn all those murky thoughts into smoke and let them just evaporate, because you are finding what's important for you, your vocation, your path, and just really what has meaning. And I have to reestablish that for myself every day. I mean, I'm not some crazy guru that's like, I know where I'm going all the time, I know what's important. Every single day it changes, and I have to look back on the day prior and say, how did I waste time? How did I fritter my energy? How did I get involved in something that sapped my energy, and how can I reduce that again? My big mantra now is reduce to produce. Less is more. Simplicity gets us to where we want to go. When I work in like 1, 2, 3s, I do it. When I get up, I have gratitude. I work towards, you know, a plan for the day, but only the next moment. I have reverence and I celebrate each step of the way, and then I just go for it. So let's see what's going to be taking place for you guys. I love, love, love this. Okay, and also one quick announcement too. If you come over to my IG, SparkQuest11, I have all kinds of fun stuff over there. Reading specials, love spreads, your 12 house spreads, all kinds of things that I'm redoing this week, because I feel like this full moon energy is still here and in effect and very helpful to do reading. So I love that. So you guys, let's start with group number one, which is becoming braver, resilience, experience, growing stronger, and fresh perspective. We all love that, right? And each day we're given that. So why aren't we moving towards that? And then number two, I love these holographic cards. They're so cool. Wake up. It's your moment for a lot of you guys to break free of any of those conditioned restraints and chains of what other people want of us, straight into what we want. Beautiful prompts from the universe to make those dreams happen right now. Big time, which I love. And number three, curiouser and curiouser. Discovery, inquiry, weirdness, and curiosity. I love that. I like discovering new things about people, places, and things and events every day, and being like, well, what's out there, and you know, what's going on. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to remove the other two decks, and we're going to put each read in center focus as well. So I'm going to let you make your choice, and then we'll begin. Okay, group one. So becoming braver. This is stepping up to anything. It can be our dreams, meeting our dreams, really taking the reins on any opportunity that comes our way, texting that person, messaging, sending emails, connecting, whatever it is that you want to create, whether it's more prosperity, whether it's a bigger name for yourself, whatever. It's like finding this alignment and that leads us to abundance. But a lot of you guys right now are embodying some huge potential that's untapped, and now you're recognizing and you're like, whoa, I have these skill sets. I should maybe start a YouTube channel, do a TED talk, connect, become a life coach, seek out Reiki, whatever it is. You guys are connecting and you are elevating to all the possibilities that show up, and you're also trusting that they are going to pay off and they are not going to become some issue. So we're just going to pull one card at a time. So ta-da, the Fool. Now, there's nothing better than this beautiful Fool card to say, you know what, trust the universe has your back. Trust that the things that you need to prosper, to elevate, to be aligned, to expand into, have faith in this, because your limitlessness is now going to be known to you. The next 6 months, you're just going to go out and go for it in a way that surprises you and your friends and your family and other people. But you do feel this big cosmic safety net. You feel that you're now aligned to just press forward and seek out all these possibilities. You have a lot of psychic potential too that's on tap that you're now starting to investigate. You might be curious about astrology, both sidereal and, you know, the regular Western practices, as well as things that have to do with crystals and healing, holistic approaches, all of this, because a lot of this is in your spiritual journey. I feel like this is going to be very important for a lot of you guys over the next 6 months, is your, yeah, not only you elevating, but you're having this beautiful and fantastic Empress energy of, I'm not going to settle for less. I am not going to say yes to things that are unappealing to me. I feel like I'm going to follow my spiritual guidance. It's going to lead me into this strong place of acceptance and really know your authentic self and praise it and have great self inner dialogue. Like, you're deserving of this. You can learn as you go. You're strong. We have this really unique thing, and I posted this over on Instagram because I feel truly voicing things aloud to ourselves help us seek this potential and feel strong in where we're going and who we are. And I feel like it's it's a bunch of things. I am divine. I am intuitive. I am expressive. I am loved. I am creative. I am grounded. All of these things, but we need to say certain things to ourselves. I am a winner. I am capable of everything I set my mind to. I do take every setback and use it to my advantage. I do. I will compare the day before and see, okay, did I fritter away time or resources that I shouldn't have? And how can I elevate my existence today, learning a lesson from that? Because I don't like to feel like I spend erratically or impulsively and then I don't have money for what I really want. You know, like if a wonderful tarot deck comes up and I'm like, oh, I shouldn't have bought, you know, that extra hat or whatever. So this saves us from remorseful feelings of frittering away things. And you are not going to be held back by fear. You're going to push forward fearlessly, knowing that you have this new kind of awareness and intuitive insight that's really deep and rich and readies you. So part of this too for you with this Fool, the Fool embodies this true listening. It listens to nature, it listens to its guides, it listens to its higher self. And because you're doing that, you're really elevating into this stronger sense of self, and you're not going to take no for an answer, and you're going to go out there and seek whatever it is you want and get those results because you have that resolve, which I love. Oh, there's your money power. Yeah, the universe is trying to deliver you abundance on an epic scale. So for some of you guys, please buy those lotto tickets, have fun, you know, play bingo, do these things, because this is a kind of just like epic universal monetary reward. And this is also however you format abundance in your life. It could be deep, rich friendships, kindred spirits, new creative endeavors, whatever it is. Over the next 6 months, you're going to feel like whatever you're partaking in is worthy of your time and effort, and you feel really good. It could be new culinary skills. I feel like some of you guys really want to learn how to bake and cook and do interesting things, make jewelry, sew. And you're really going to go for it. And some of you guys can turn that into revenue streams too, because ta-da, beautiful surprise awaits. You really are gifted and talented in this area. That's why you're being pulled towards that. And this creative bent is you listening to your intuitive self, listening to the higher truth, channeling, expressing yourself from a place of, wow, I'm really excited about this and I know I can do this if I really try. So you guys, some of the things coming in, this worldly acceptance, you know, I am where I am right now and I know I'm ever evolving and I'm going to be feeling great, and so therefore opening doors of creativity, your authentic self really out there and participating in a big way in the world. And when we have all this energy, we're not saying to ourselves, how can I fit in? How should I look, speak? What should I buy, wear, dress to fit in? More like, this is me, take it or leave it. And then you just fit in naturally and beautifully, because people love an authentic spirit when you just come out as you are and you're not always agreeable. You have your own mindset on something. It doesn't mean you want to argue, but you do like to have a healthy debate. You feel strong. You feel like there's a lot of wisdom to be garnered out there because your guides are showing you the way, and it makes for a brighter day. It makes for more, you know, more limitlessness, more creativity, but a really healthy, strong perspective on what you can have achieved and the momentum that you gain from each little win. You kind of put it in that front pocket and go, you know what? I'm ready for another surprise. So your main thing over the next 6 months is great monetary wins, great creative endeavors, a lot of on tap potential now being tapped to create this abundance and feeling loved and cared for by the universe and others. So you have this, like, the fool's capacity of, I can stand on that cliff's edge and shout, I'm ready, and really have these dreams come forth. So a lot of you guys, wow, you are going to places that you were afraid to open the door for before, but now you're like, you know what? I deserve this. I deserve this universal surprise. I deserve abundance. I deserve love. I deserve caring, and I deserve to really have great, unique surprises out there and generate exciting, electric, sizzling energy into my life. And that's exactly what's taking place. So beautiful energy, you guys. Love it for you. If you're new to my channel, welcome. Don't forget to press like and subscribe. All my links are down below. If they're not, they're on the prior ones, because Ian, he puts them on for me, but I'd love for you to come over to IG and come follow. I do daily posts of memes, tarot related, astrology, mental wellness, all kinds of things that are meant to inspire and lift and make you feel good about you. I know there are some awesome, awesome sites out there, and I peruse them daily, and I just kind of garner all the best, and I place them over there too. Artworks, things of that nature too. Things that I purchase and really love in terms of decks as well. Just all kinds of fun things, and I'm running those specials as well. So Love and Light Group 1, fantastic energy. Okay, beautiful Group 2. Ooh, loving this for you. Wake up. It is your moment. It's your moment for success. That's why I have these certain stones out here too. Watermelon, tourmaline, beautiful citrine, the stone of luck and abundance and wealth, and jade with the dragon's strong, fierce energy to go out and attain whatever you want. If you guys are ever curious, come over to IG, and I do direct sales through there for anything that people see that they like. If it hasn't made it to my Etsy store, you can just say, hey, I saw this on the set and I really liked it. How much is that? Is it available? And I definitely believe in the properties of stones, and I always have them around me, and I do feel like I am very lucky and abundant due to the fact I always carry citrine. I have a huge citrine I carry in my purse, and it's carved citrine. It's so gorgeous. But you guys, let's just talk about that, because your moment's coming and I want to see what it is going to avail you of. Oh, it doesn't get any better than this. Ta-da! Here you are in the world of magic, because you're realizing, hey, my life is not about being rich, popular, or highly educated or perfect. It's about being real. It's about being kind. It's about being the person that can manifest whatever they want when they want it by true gratitude and belief, you know, using the law of assumption. I assume I will be well liked and I will handle this beautifully and I'll have my act together and things will be gracious and beautiful. And because of that, you're absolutely manifesting this. I want to pull a secondary card to see what also this is pertaining to. Okay. So you're going to be breaking over the next 60 days that or 6 months, that those chains that used to bind you, addiction to certain things, that can be social media, that can be a fixation on one individual that just kind of distracts you and causes madness. This can be on exes. This could be on what we think is a perceived failure. But those chains that bind us, you are transmuting addiction and being chained to something. And this is also, you guys, you are breaking out of this mindset of there's only so much to go around, or lack mentality, or when are things going to get better. You're going to start utilizing the power and energy you have right now to manifest whatever you want in your life. But this is saying goodbye to things that just don't serve you anymore, that aren't healthy, over indulging in anything, chemicals or otherwise, foods, using things as crutches, and just breaking free of that and creating the dream life that you want. Ta-da! Some of you guys, the love of your life is going to be showing you up a-okay. This is a beautiful manifestation of love that you've probably been focused on. Like, some of you guys, it is a very clear message. Somebody that, again, you feel like you were fixated on and they had no interest, or they just seem like they weren't showing care, affection, or love or support in any way. They're going to come back in a big way. They were doing some shadow work. They now feel compelled to connect with you. Some of you guys, absolute soulmate connection, boom, just spur of the moment. You are out doing something naturally. You are at a coffee shop, some new person at work, at your school, university, wherever you are, just shows up and it is fireworks galore. Again, remember, the way you speak to yourself matters. And right now, self-care is going to be a necessity. You're going to make good decisions. You are going to have beautiful guided visualizations for yourself for this love. It's really important. This is a powerful cosmic shift happening where a lot of people are manifesting their soulmates over the next 6 months. They really are. But how they're doing it, again, they're aligned with their highest self. They have a high frequency and vibrational set point by doing things that are good for them, ingesting good food, exercising, listening to their higher self, letting go of dead wood, people, places, and things that don't serve them. They are realizing results happen over time. They don't need immediate gratification. So they're patient and they're not letting their mind bully their body. And you're not like, when you eat certain things, you're not feeling like, oh, so shameful and bad. You don't think you have to be this specific ideal. Your life isn't yours if you always care what someone else thinks. So now you're letting that drop away. I think that's a big thing for a lot of you guys, family and friends. You want to pursue the true you and your authentic path. So you're not path, you're not caring what other people think and say or how they evaluate you. You're like, take care to evaluate yourself. I'll see you later. You are just going forward, not looking back, because you're not going that way. And anybody else says something's impossible, that is their opinion or their viewpoint, because you are creating the life of your dreams. When you have the Magician and the Ace of Cups, you feel fueled and loved, but you're also recognizing, hey, I am going to make sure my cup is always full. And then if I have overflow in the little cup down below, that's when I give. That's when I reach out and care for others. But my cup, I can't give from my main cup, because if it can't be replenished in time, my bandwidth will be spent. I will be too lean. And now you're recognizing self-care is super important. I respect and have always had people that care for themselves and take those care days and say no thank you, and they don't have to participate in everything, and they don't have to be so thirsty for everybody to look at them and be part of everything because they feel like they're going to miss out. I love that. My mother had that capacity in spades, for sure. Like, there could be raging parties or wild things going on, and she never felt like she had to jump on the bandwagon for the next best thing or style or whatever. She had her own style, and she just was like happy and content because she had this. She recognized, whoa, I'll get hives and freak the hell out being an empath and having the spiritual gifts that she had. She's like, I can't be everywhere at once, nor do I want to be. I don't need to be everybody's savior, but I do need to look out for myself. And that's what you're going to recognize. And by looking out for yourself, you're creating your dream life. So a lot of you guys, you artists out there, you're going to see a huge spike in interest in your art, in your creativity, and whatever you're putting out there, because you are putting your whole heart and effort in it, and you don't care how it compares to others. You do not feel like you are validated by others, and that's what creates success. You realize when you validate your own work and you realize it's from a place of love and your authentic space, that's what creates this massive abundance and love overflow. So some of you guys, this is really amazing. Just pay attention to the signs and synchronicities. Create a visualization of what your optimal and most perfect kind of love and warm, silly situation could be with this person. I love people with sense of humor that are just completely themselves. Like, I love people that don't judge and criticize and feel like, I don't like a lot of sarcasm when it's at somebody else's expense. I just like when people are just freewheeling and fun and they point out the beauty and magic all around. Like, Joni is so wonderful. My offspring, when we go out, like, we'll notice all the birds and bees and dogs and behaviors and little things and finds it so wonderful and fascinating and rocks. Forget about my whole family. We go to a beach or a crystal shop and rocks and all of that. We are just immersed in that moment because it's magical. And that's what you're creating for yourself. The Magician says, what makes me sparkle and dazzle and feel wonderful and ignite my passions? And that's what you'll be seeking. And you're going to evolve into this like supernova of creativity. So that is definitely your keyword over the next 6 months. And I'm loving that for you because it'll be so freeing. It'll be so, so freeing. You are going to become the best version of you, and everything will be so good. You're just not even going to believe it. You're not going to be waiting for Friday, for summer, for someone to love you. Happiness is achieved when you stop waiting for it and you make the most of the moment. And because you're doing that, it just shows up for you in spades. So I love that for you, group two. Comment down below if this is you and you feel this and you're excited. I love this. Again, you guys, love and light. Thank you for people that support through Patreon and just reads and my specials and the people that come over to IG and participate in all the fun specials that I do over there. You guys are the absolute best. Congratulations, group two. You are going to be immersed into a magical place, and your dreams are going to be coming so true. But this freedom you're going to feel stepping away from this is going to just be like, oh, the just
You feel light, like you could absolutely fly, which is wonderful.
Okay, group three. I love this. Curiouser and curious. I love this because this also talks about our teachability, discovery, inquiry, weirdness, and curiosity. This is you not caring how other people gauge or kind of peg you to be at, because you know that you have this deep, rich imagination, and you want to see what life, what spirituality, what people, what endeavors you want to go check out are all about. This is you taking care of you and being the best version of you and going out and shining and being absolutely amazing. Ta-da! Here you go. I'm already loving this. So how fantastic is this right now? We are no longer going to be conflicted over who we are or where we're going, because what you're going to do is set a wonderful, healthy set of boundaries for other people, because five can be a card of conflict. When we say yes to things we don't want to say yes to, we feel like, oh, we are taking away from ourselves, right? If we're always doing favors and giving away our resources, we sometimes have this awareness that we're not being replenished by other people or by ourselves in a way that we need. So now you're going to get this message of passion. Something is going to arrive. You're going to view something on YouTube or somewhere that sparks and ignites this passion in you, and it just takes off. And I want to see what's going on. So this is a huge creative upswing and cycle for you. Now, what you'll be relinquishing here is overthinking things. I feel like you guys were having a moment. Look at all these fives for you. So let's talk about your magic numbers here are going to be 555. But you guys have experienced, some of you guys, literal like mind overload, like those cogs and your brain could not stop thinking and logisticating and planning. And what happened is you almost felt like you were getting mental burnout. Like, I cannot plan for next week, next month, 6 months. To you, all of that, like you're over planning, and what's happening is it can create anxiety that makes us paralytic. We can't do anything because our mind is so jammed. So what you're going to do is release this energy again, release this fear of anything, lack mentality, because some of you guys, a lot of it had to do with money, like how am I going to pay for this, how am I going to cover this cost, and a lot of you guys have been worried about money, but that's going to be alleviated because you're going to really be cycling up economically, mentally, strengthening yourself so you don't feel like you're inundated by this. And I want to just pull a clarifier on this. Your fives are amazing right here, you guys. Like 555 is definitely going to be your beautiful spiritual number. But weirdly enough, that five, we have to be careful in that. Five is, again, it's a thing of conflict, because Five of Swords, again, is like people not thinking like us, so we feel opposed to their direction. But what they are trying to do, or have been trying to do, unfortunately, I need a quick sip of coffee because this is very clear. Some of you guys, your angels and guides want you to know, it doesn't matter how conflicted, annoying, or unsupportive your family members are, whether they're like an embarrassment to you, they bring up issues over and over, they criticize you, they're just not a healthy set point for you to feel like you have solid ground. What you need to do is basically negate any of their opinions of you, because what happens if we don't have healthy boundaries, we let their opinions come in and we take them on board, and then our boat gets really heavy. But now you want to sail away from that, and you are going to do that. And you're like, you know what? Just because other people don't see the potential in me and or think that I'm in this role of child or helpless or whatever, ineptitude, it's simply not true. And now you're taking these reins. So you're going to listen to spiritual guidance. So you have this new awareness of yourself. You have this idea of yourself and a higher truth that you can express yourself how you want. You can be your authentic self. And you're really great in vibe awareness right now, because the Emperor gets the vibe of everything. It needs to know, where do I need to fortify? What direction do I need to move? But you are going to feel really, you're going to uncomplicate what you complicated for no reason with that Ten of Swords, that overthinking. Listen, I have to simplify my life. I have to simplify how I operate. And that means I don't need more. I need less right now. So I'm going to unburden myself of, it could be like, I don't need to go to this person for any kind of opinion, because it always comes out haphazard and it annoys me and they're critical and I don't need that. So why am I bringing it on board? I don't need to participate in anybody else's crap energy, because I want an equal exchange. I want acceptance of me. I want love. I want supportive relationships. I want a softening of energy.
I want compassion. And therefore, when you realize it's not reciprocated, you're going to move on and you're going to feel fulfilled. Again, you're going to be strongly motivated and have this sense of confidence and encourage yourself, reclaiming your power. Bye-bye victimhood. You are now in a self-empowered state where you're going to get whatever it is you need. So you guys, this may be in business. You're like, you know what? I'm not corporate. Goodbye. I'm going a creative endeavor. You know what? I'm not going to ask for my family's validation in this because it's always a big debate and I don't need this anymore. You know what? I'm not going to email or listen or respond to my friend that just does power dumps and emotional dumps on me, but doesn't ask permission like, hey, do you have the bandwidth or time to hear this? I am not going to communicate on or social media or things that make me feel less than. Again, people are always posting their big wins. People don't post the everyday, the mundane, or their losses, right? So it may seem like people are super high achieving, but we all have those high set points at some point in our life, right? And now you're working on yours and you're going to achieve. You guys, in the next 6 months, your dream job, your dream whatever, get being certified in what you ever want to be certified in, a wonderful relationship, wherever you're really wanting to create some magic in your life, you're going to be able to do this. Again, super motivated, encouraged, self-empowered. Again, no more of this. You are now allowing, receiving your highest good. Fantastic creative expression. A lot of beautiful, rich, like observations about things, a really healthy perspective on love and life and giving yourself credit where credit is due. You're a phenomenal person, and sometimes we forget about that where we're busy listening to other people and their interpretation of us. And now you're interpreting yourself from your true authentic place, that you're trying, that you are going to succeed, that you are worth this, that you're going to walk through that door and you're going to say yes, that you're strong, grounded, intuitive, and gorgeously expressive, and you deserve this rich life. You deserve wonderful, great kindred spirits around you, and you're not going to settle for less. So this is you guys just leveling up in every department, your frequency, your vibration, how you feel about yourself, what you know you're deserving of. You're going to walk through that door and say, this is my door, and guess what? I'm going to kill it. This is going to be great. And you're going to just feel wonderful, because why should you feel otherwise? We are all created different in different aspects and times and variations of success in different ways. And because now you're understanding that your potential to succeed is always trying to bubble up, and this time you're just going to let it turn into a geyser. You're like, dude, it is now raining oil and gold on my parade, and I deserve this. And you're going to be feeling good. And again, you're like, what the hell was I even listening to these other people for? Like, why? And again, I love that quote that the least successful people listen to their neighbors, their friends, and their families. Because it's true, you get pulled in so many directions. You're like a pinball. You don't know what's what. But when you listen to yourself, your higher self, you will succeed, and that's what you're doing now. And I love that for you, group three. Beautiful. Comment down below if this was you and you feel this potential just rising to the surface, this golden path that's set in front of you, and you're feeling good. Really great time for actors and spokesmodels and people on YouTube. Really great time to ascend and garner a huge fan base as well, because I feel like you guys are really sparkling and dazzling and really leveling up, and you have something to offer. Everybody's unique perspective is wonderful and electric, and yours even more so at this time. So love and light.